Hello everyone! Welcome to our EPP TLE 6. We are now on our third week for second quarter.
Learn
and enjoy! Our objectives for this session, first is to enumerate types of orchard farms. Second, identify trees appropriate for orchard gardening. And the last one is to apply the proper way of planting and propagating trees and fruit trees. Let's find out what are the common types of orchards.
First,
we have banana plantation. Native to Southeast Asia, the banana is a large, herbaceous plant with a perennial root. It usually bears fruit within 10 months. Philippines has consistently been in the list of top 5 banana-producing countries in the world. It is the leading fruit grown in the country and the biggest dollar earner. Davao Region, Northern Mindanao, and Sacsayhuaman are among the highest producers. Second, we have citrus or what we call calamansi plantation. Native to Southeast Asia, calamansi is characterized by wing-like appendages on the leaf stalks, white or fur-flesh flowers and fruits. Here in our country, one of the top calamansi producing province is Mindoro Oriental. The next one is mango plantation. Native to India, the mango tree grows up to 15 feet high with spreading top and numerous branches. It is widely grown in the tropics for its succulent fruit. The fruit, which is a fleshy drupe, is somewhat kidney-shaped. Areas with at least 4 to 5 dry months are ideal for growing mangoes. In the Philippines, among the top mango-producing provinces are Pangasinan, Zambales, Isabela, Cebu, Davao, and Cotabato. Another one is durian plantation. Native to the hot, humid rainforest of Southeast Asia, the durian fruit is round and egg-shaped and usually weighs 2.8 to 3.5 kilograms. It requires 3 months to develop and ripen. In the Philippines, the top producers of durian are Davao del Norte, Compostela Valley, and North Cotabato. The next one is palm trees plantation. Palm is the common name for family of woody flowering plants widespread in the tropics. They are of great economic importance because of the food, fiber, and oil they provide. And the last one is coconut plantation. The tree called coconut palm has cylindrical trunk about 45 centimeters in diameter and can grow up to 25 meters high. The mature coconut is oval shaped and has a thick fibrous outer husk and hard inner shell. Here in our country, coconut production plays a significant role in the economy. About 25% of cultivated land in the country are planted in coconut trees. That is equivalent to about 3.6 hectares. And now, let's find out what are the kind of trees appropriate for orchard gardening based on location, climate, and market demand. In terms of location, trees grown from hillside. We have coconut, palm tree, mango, and pili nut. For sloping area, we have mango, coconut, cashew, palm tree, and pili nut. In the valley, we have durian, banana, papaya, and mangosteen. Plains, we have banana, mango, citrus, dragon fruit, and coconut. Also, we have guava, star apple, santol, and jackfruit. And now, let us find out what are the fruit trees appropriate for orchard gardening based on climate. For elevated or cold areas, we have grapes and pomelo. Fruit trees appropriate for lowly or warm climate, we have mango, coconut, banana, guava, and durian. And now, let us find out what are the trees appropriate for dry season. First, we have banana, pili nut, palm tree, dragon fruit, papaya, guava, and star apple. These are the list of fruit trees appropriate for wet season. We have durian, banana, and mango. And now, let us find out the kind of trees appropriate for orchard gardening based on market demand. These are the list of fruit trees appropriate for market demand. We have mango, banana, citrus, dragon fruit, jackfruit, guava, star apple, santol, and coconut. Let's find out what are the ways of planting and propagating trees and fruit-bearing trees. There are two ways of propagating and planting trees and fruit-bearing trees. First, we have sexual propagation, and the other one is asexual propagation. Sexual propagation. Propagation using vulnerable seeds. Those seeds have the capacity to germinate and grow. What about asexual propagation? Asexual propagation meaning the production of new plants from leaves, stems, and roots. It can be done manually, either naturally, or using scientific method. For example, budding, marketing, and grafting. And now let us define budding. Budding is a process by which the scion is inserted into the rootstock to unite and grow as one. It is done by choosing and cutting a bud from one plant and attaching it to another plant. The bud must fit well to the mother plant. When the bud grows big, it will become part of the plant. What is marketing? Marketing is a process wherein a ring of bark on a large branch is removed. The inner surface is scraped lightly and rubbed with moist soil covered with plastic sheets or cocoa husk, and secured tightly on both ends with twine. When roots have developed, the marcot is cut and transplanted in a pot or a plastic bag. What is grafting? Grafting is a process wherein the stem of one plant, or what we call the mother plant, is inserted into another plant. The two units are formed into another plant. Examples are mango, guava, and santol. And now, I know that all of you are ready for the evaluation. Get your pen and paper and answer the following questions. Choose the letter of the correct answer. Here is our first question. It is a plantation of trees or shrubs that is maintained for food production. A. Garden. B. Park. C. Orchard. D. Nursery. You have 5 seconds to answer. And the correct answer is letter C, orchard. Very good. Second question is, what is the common name for a family of woody flowering plants widespread in the tropics? A, palm. B, banana. C, mango. D, coconut. You have 5 seconds to answer. And the correct answer is letter A, palm. Very good. The third question is, it refers to the place where trees and fruit-bearing trees grow. A. Climate. B. Location. C. Market. D. Supply. You have 5 seconds to answer. And the correct answer is letter B, location. Very good. For our next question, it is a process by which the scion is inserted into the rootstock to unite and grow as one. A. Grafting. B. Marcoting. C. Marcoting. D. Budding. You have 5 seconds to answer. And the correct answer is letter D, budding. Very good. And for the last question, it is a process wherein a ring of bark on a large branch is removed. The inner surface is scraped lightly and wrapped with moist soil covered with plastic sheets or cocoa husk and secured tightly on both ends with twine. A. Grafting. B. Marcoting. C. marcotane. D, budding. You have 5 seconds to answer. And the correct answer is letter B, marcotane. Very good. Good work. Congratulations, kids, for a job well done. See you again on our next lesson. Bye. Please don't forget to like, share, and subscribe. Thank you.